Don't be queasy. Make your bet. Winning is easy on Card Sharks. And here's the host of Card Sharks, Jim Perry.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you for joining us at home. Come on down and join us in the studio sometime. Thank you. And, yeah, make your bet. Winning is easy. Well, it sure has been for our current champion. We'll tell you how much he's won in just a few moments. Right now, we thank Mike Connolly from Lansing, Michigan, for that opening call. And thank you, Mike. Now let's get to the cards. Dennis and Bettina, if you will, load in the cards. And you can see we have a game in progress with these card charts. Jeff Wine, our champion.
How you doing, Jim?
Good to see you again.
Good to see you, too.
Our theater manager. You said you're going to get married. How long before you're getting married?
We got to set a date.
Oh, you haven't set the date yet?
Yes. Proposition 13 held us back.
Oh, yes?
Yes.
Why is that?
Well, she had to find a job.
Got a little cut back there. Mm-hmm. I don't think she needs the money quite as much now, because we were just alluding to that a moment there. Jeff has won $27,000 in cash.
Oh, thank you.
You're a good champion.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Our challenger is Carol Phillips. Hello, Carol. Nice to see you again.
Fine, thank you.
And you are getting married soon as well.
Yes.
Have you set a date?
Yes, hopefully. Well, it's a tentative date, but hopefully New Year's Eve.
Good. Oh, isn't that nice? Yes. And you're bringing six...
That way he can't forget the anniversary, right?
Good thinking. And you're bringing six children between you, right?
Yes, I have three and he has three. Good. So we have a house full.
Good luck in the marriage. Good luck
thank
to both
you very
of you here
much.
In the game. You're nice people. Each of you
thank
have a deck
you.
Of 52 playing cards. They're shuffled. The players cut them before we go on the air. Jeff, the champion, plays the upper cards, the red cards. Carol, the challenger, the lower cards, the blue cards. And as you can see, as we left off, Jeff needs four cards. Carol needs just one to win the first game of the best two out of three match. Before you can begin calling high-low on the cards, you must win a high-low toss-up question. Carol, as we left off, the question is going to you.
Okay.
And Carol, we asked 100 single women, have you ever said no to a man when you really meant yes? How many women said they had?
Oh, definitely. That's happened many times. You know, the mother's old warnings about beware, but inside you want to say yes, but you have to say no. I'm going to say 63.
63 said no when they really meant yes, Jeff.
Oh, no. Guys don't know what no means. You know, no means yes to them. I think it's higher.
Higher than
higher.
That. Well, the actual number of single women who have said no to a man when they really meant yes is 67. It's higher. Jeff, you go to the board first.
Do it, Jim.
Jeff, we left off with a jack as your base card. Whenever you win the question, you have the right to change it. Do you want to play that jack or change it?
No, I'll play it, Jim. I'll play it. Let's go lower. Lower.
Lower than a jack.
All
yes,
right.
With a three.
Good card. Good card. We're on the roll. Higher. Higher.
Higher than a three. It is
all
a nine.
Right.
Remember, you can freeze at any time.
Freeze.
Go freeze. Jeff needs two cards. Carol needs one. And the question goes to you, Jeff. Our man on the street stopped 100 people on Broadway in New York City and asked them how old they were. How many of those people refused to tell him how old they were?
Oh, I don't think. I would tell my age. I think most everybody would. I think it's high. I say 95.
No,
95.
How many refused to tell him?
Refused to tell
yes.
him. Oh, five refused to tell him.
Five refused to tell him how old they were, Carol.
People are very sensitive about their ages. I don't care whether they're male or female. The vanity is there, and I'm going to say it's higher.
Higher than that?
Yes.
The actual number of people who refused to tell our man on the street how old they were is 81. Yes, it's very much higher. Carol.
All right.
Sure, Jeff. You're 23. It's easy for you to say.
That's true. That's true.
Carol, you've got an eight. Do you want to play it?
No way. I don't like those eights.
A big change, needing just one card. It is a seven. Little better.
I'm afraid that's not much help, but I'm going to have to say higher.
If this is higher, you've got the first game in the match, Carol. And, no, it's another seven. It is not higher. And, Jeff, that gives you a chance to play off the nine and call this.
Lower, Jim, lower.
Lower than a nine. Yes,
right,
a three.
Higher, Jim. Higher, Jim, higher.
Higher than a three for the win.
Higher,
he did
higher.
It for the four. Jeff pulls it out again. Game one to the champion and $100. We'll set up for game two coming up right after this commercial message. I thought you had it,
guys. I thought so, too.
There are bodies running off the stage right here. I don't understand. We'll set up for game two here. And, Carol, you need this game. Those are the same two decks of cards. Carol, we asked 100 women who support the woman's liberation movement. Have you ever asked a man for a date? How many feminists said they had asked a man out for a date?
Oh, my goodness. I am not a women's liber. Oh, boy. It's becoming more and more popular. I understand that. And with, you know, my son gets phone calls from girls all the time. I'm going to say it's pretty... Oh, I'll say maybe 43.
43 have asked a man out for a date, Jeff.
That's higher than that, Jim. It's higher.
Yes? That's more common.
Yes.
The actual number of feminists who've asked a man out for a date is 76. It is much more common, Jeff. Wow. Jeff, your base card is a king.
Like that cowboy, Jim. Lower on that cowboy.
Lower than a king. A five.
Good card. Higher, Jim.
Higher than a five. It is an eight.
I'll freeze, Jim.
Jeff needs two cards to get back up to the money cards, Jeff. We asked 100 expectant fathers. These are all men whose wives are at least 6 months pregnant. Have you had any morning sickness? How many expectant fathers said they had morning sickness?
Oh, I think some of them have, but I wouldn't think it's that high. I'll say about 30.
30 have had morning sickness, Carol.
There are a few who have the little sympathy pains, but I'm going to say that it's lower.
You say lower than that. I always had a sore back. You say lower, Carol.
Yes.
The actual number of expectant fathers who empathized with their wives and had morning sickness is 9. Very much lower, Carol.
All right.
Yes. Carol, your base card, a 5. Do you want it?
I'm going to stay with the 5 and say the next card is higher.
Higher than a 5? Yes, a jack.
I'm going to go on and say the next card is lower.
Lower than a jack. It is a 9.
I'm going to freeze, Jim.
Freezing it. Move the freeze bar over. We've got a tie. Each player needs 2 cards for the win. Carol needs this game. Carol, we asked 100 people. Even when you've done nothing wrong, do you still feel nervous when you see a policeman? How many people do feel nervous when they see a policeman?
Oh, definitely. If I'm driving along the freeway and I see one in my rearview mirror, automatically I slow down to 45 instead of 55. I think that's just a natural reaction. I'm going to say 73 people.
73 people feel nervous when they see a policeman, Jeff.
I'm a very nervous person. And I've almost had an accident seeing a policeman. I think it's higher.
Higher than higher. The actual number of people who feel nervous when they see a policeman is 52, not higher, Carol.
Just
a little more than 50, though. Carol, you've got a 9. Do you want it?
No, I think I'd like to change it.
This could be a big change, Carol. You get
please.
A 3.
Yeah. All right. The next card has got to be higher.
Higher than a 3. No, a 2. And a break for Jeff to play off an 8 and call this.
Higher, Jim.
Higher than an 8. Yes, a king!
That cowboy looks awful good. It's got to be low.
This is lower. Jeff goes back to the money cards for the win. He did it again! He's unbelievable, yeah. He finds ways to win. Carol, thank you for joining us.
Thank you very much.
Here's a nice parting gift. Good luck in the marriage, Carol.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for joining us. Carol Phillips, come on down here. Believe it, you're doing it so often. Jeff Wine is going to try to add to his over $27,000 right after we take time out for this. Back with our champion who is doing beautifully, Jeff Wine. Are you going to do it again?
I certainly hope so, Jim.
You've had super cards. What did you say about me as a dealer in Las Vegas?
You get thrown out of that city in no time. You've given me the best cards.
I hope I can do it again. Step one up there. Let's open the board and get to the money cards, Jeff. And you won another $200 in that game. Yours to keep. We always give you new money to play with the money cards. Brand new deck of cards as well, all shuffled and cut. We'll give you $200 on the bottom level and 3 cards to play with. Move up to the second level, another $200 of betting money and 3 more cards. Minimum bets of $50 till you get to the top card, the big bet, where you must bet at least half the money. Jeff, keep up the good work. That's all I can say. Here's
Thanks.
$200.
Thanks, Jim. Thanks.
As in the game, you have a choice of 2 base cards on the bottom level. Remember, when you move to the second level, again, you can change your your base card, and you can change it once again before you make the big bet. Right now, you're going to start with a 9. You can change it.
Toss it out, Jim. Let's toss it out.
Got to play this one. Next card off the top of the deck, and it is a 7. Ooh, that's the first time you've started off with a tough card, Jeff.
$50 and it's higher, Jim.
Taking the minimum bet, $50 higher than a 7. It is a king, and you bought a goodie. $250 and a king.
All of it, Jim, all of it, that it's lower.
$250 lower than a king. Yes!
All right.
You double it to $500 with a 10.
Tough card, tough card. $100 lower.
$100 lower than a 10.
Deuce.
A 3. Will you take that?
Great card.
That goes to 3. We'll give you the other $200 of betting money. Jeff, you've got $800. Do you want the 3?
All of it. The whole bundle of wax. Higher. Do it, Jim.
$100.
Do it.
Higher than a 3.
All right. All right.
$1,600 and a 9 now.
Tough card. Tough card. $200, it's lower. Not many low cards out there. It's got to be lower.
All right. $200 bet that this card is lower than a 9. It is another 3. $1,800 and a 3.
$1,800, Jim. $1,800, that it's higher.
All
give it
of it
to
again.
Me. Let's see an ace. We could use it.
Higher than a 3 for an $1,800 bet. Oh, no! That you could do no wrong, Jeff.
Oh, I didn't think so either.
That's the first time you have failed, but... Well, I don't think you mind too much, though, do you? Come on down here, Jeff. I mean, one failure out of a cup four, right?
Yeah.
And $27,200, you can afford one once in a while. That was a tough one. It was a good bet, though.
Oh, I thought so.
We'll meet a new challenger right after this. It's the first time the cards turned against you. Champion Jeff Wine, $27,200. Now, Jeff, you were extolling my virtues as a dealer. I hate to ask this, but with a 3, and then I dealt you a 2. How do I stack up now?
Fantastic.
Oh, you're
fantastic still. That's only one bad card.
You're a nice fella, Jeff.
Fantastic cards.
Yep. Well, here we go, Jeff. Let's see if you can hang on to that championship with 2 brand new decks of cards and a new challenger on Card Charge. Mezzacapa. Hi, Annie. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too. Hi, Jeff.
You have some friends here with you?
Yes, I do. All my brother, my sister-in-law, and my brother-in-law are here.
Isn't that nice? Tell us more about yourself.
Well, I'm from Santa Ana, California. My name is Annie Mezzacapa. I'm a law student, and I'm about to enter my final semester of law studies, and I'm just 4 classes away from taking the bar exam.
Oh, terrific. That's nice. That's nice. Good to have you here, Annie.
Nice to be here.
You'll play the lower cards, the blue cards. Jeff will play the upper cards, the red cards. And Jeff, we asked 100 married men, did you steal your wife away from another man? How many men claim they stole their wife away from another man?
Oh, I think they find their own. I don't think they do that. And it would usually come from their best friend. I think it's low. I say about 20.
About 20.
20.
Said they stole their wife away from another man, Annie.
Even if they really didn't steal their wife away, a man likes to think he beat someone else out to win her hand. So I think it'll be slightly higher than
you
that.
You say higher.
Yes, higher.
The actual number of men who stole their wife away from another man is 25. Higher, Annie.
Okay.
Annie, your base card is a jack.
Oh,
do you want it?
Okay. I'll go lower than the jack.
Lower than a jack? It is
okay,
an 8.
But I'll freeze on the 8. Freeze on the 8.
Right there, and that keeps Jeff away from his cards. Annie, the question to you. Our man on the street went to Italy, where he asked 100 women in Milan, do you believe a woman's place is in the home? How many Italian women said a woman's place is in the home?
Coming from an Italian heritage and Italian, I'd have to say that would be fairly high. I'm going to go at least 75 on that.
75 yeah. Italian women said a woman's place is in the home, Jeff.
Takes a lot of time to cook the pasta. I think it's higher.
Even higher than
that? Higher.
The actual number of Italian women who believe a woman's place is in the home is 13. Not higher, Annie.
Change that 8.
They're a lot more liberal over there than we thought. Changing the 8 to a jack.
Okay. Next card lower than a jack.
Lower than a jack. Yes, the 9.
I'm going to try. than the 9.
You're going to risk it.
Yeah.
Lower than a 9. No, it's a queen. The risk did not pay off, and you lose both those cards, and you give Jeff a chance to play a 10.
Not bad. Lower, Jim, lower.
Lower than a 10. It is a 9, yes.
Lower. Tough card. Lower, Jim, lower.
And Jeff is going to risk it on the 9. Yes, a 4, he did it.
Higher, Jim. Give it to me.
Higher than a 4. It is another 9.
I'm going to stop right there, Jim. Freeze.
Freezing it as Jeff needs 1 card. We'll fill in the spaces, and he needs 3. Jeff, we asked 100 married women. If you were at a neighbor's house and her laundry really did look cleaner than yours, would you ask her what detergent she used? How many women said they would ask their neighbor what she used?
Oh, I don't think so. I think most women take pride in their laundry.
It is something to be proud of, isn't
low.
It?
I'd say about 23.
23 would ask what detergent was used, Annie.
Well, if it was really whiter and cleaner and the whole thing, I think they might ask. So I think it would, out of 100 women, I think it might be a little higher than 23.
A little higher.
Yeah.
The actual number of married women who, if their neighbor's laundry looked cleaner than theirs, would ask what she used is 71. Annie, it's higher. Guess people will look for the better product regardless. We've got a jack. Annie, would you like to change it or play it?
I think I'll keep the jack, and I will go lower.
Lower than a jack? Yes, with a 7.
Please on that 7.
You're
Please.
Not going to take the chance again. No. It is sudden death. Someone has to win with this play of the cards. Each player, Jeff needs 1, excuse me, and Annie needs 2. This decides that all-important control. Annie, we asked 100 men. Be honest. Did you have your first alcoholic drink before you were of legal age? How many men admitted that they did have their first drink before they were of legal age?
I think many men have had their drink before legal age. I'm going on... I'll go 93
had their first drink before they were of legal age, Jeff.
Well, I had mine at 17 and my dad caught me. I think it's higher.
Even higher than that?
Higher than that.
The actual number of men who admitted that they had their first drink before they were of legal age is 95. It's higher, Jeff. Jeff, you need 1 card. Annie needs 2. Your decision, do you want to play it or pass it?
I'll be a gentleman. It's yours, Annie. It's yours.
He wants to play it. Pass it. Annie, you have a 7. You cannot change it. You must turn over both cards to win. 1 mistake and Jeff wins. What is this card?
Let's see. It's 7. I think... Seven.
Going against the odds, she thinks it is lower than a 7. No, another 7 is not lower, and Jeff wins the first game in sudden death. Let us continue on to game 2, Janice, if you will. Jeff, I think in every match that you've had, as you've gone to sudden death, you have had that all-important control with the sudden death question. That's most important. Annie, got to make a comeback now. He's got game 1. Here are the next cards off the top of the deck for game 2. Jeff, we asked 100 single women. When you have dinner with a man, do you ever leave food on your plate just so he won't think you're a pig? How many women said they do leave food on their plate?
I think so. With dieting being in and everything, I like to show a petite appetite. I'll say pretty low. I say 23.
How many said they do leave food on their plate? 23. Leave food on their plate. Annie?
I think it will be slightly higher than that because they would. It's a common thing to do. I think it'll be higher.
You say higher?
Yes.
The actual number of single women who, when they have dinner with a man, leave food on the plate is 36. It's higher. Annie? Annie, your base card is a 6. Do you want it?
I'd like to change the base card, please.
You won the question. You can change it to an 8.
Oh, great. Lower than the 8.
Lower than an 8. It is a 3.
Higher
than a 3. Yes, a 6. Freezing it. Annie needs 2 cards to tie up the match. Annie, we asked 100 married men. If your wife could make $100 a day giving massages to men at a health spa, would you let her take the job? How many men said they would let their wife take the job?
Well, I don't think a lot of men would want their wife in that environment.
Quickly now, Annie.
So I think it'll be around 25.
25 would let him take the job. Jeff?
No, they don't. The title's no good. I think they want him in the home. I say lower.
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 The actual number of men who would let their wife work at a health spa giving massages to men is 34. It's not lower. Annie.
Changing
that six very quickly to an eight. Oh. You're right up the middle, Annie. What is this?
Higher than the eight.
Higher than an eight. No, it's a two. And a free chance for Jeff to play an ace.
Great. Lower, lower, Jim.
Lower than an ace. It is a five.
Higher, higher, Jim.
Higher than a five. No, a two. He could not advance. We'll fill in the spaces, and we'll be right back right after this commercial message. Have a good day. See you next time on Car Charge. Bye-bye.
A representative of the studio audience may receive Oneida Silversmith's gift certificate, allowing you to select your own showplace gifts for entertaining and gift-giving needs, including your choice of luxurious stainless flatware and silver-plated hollowware furnished by Oneida. And some of our contestants will receive West Bend's Electric Oriental Wok for international entertaining or everyday meals. It's ideal for stir-frying, simmering, and stewing. And be everything you can be with Mary Kay Cosmetics, skincare, and glamour cosmetics presented to you in your home by trained beauty consultants, Mary Kay Cosmetics, Dallas, Texas, and a 22-piece Master Mechanic multi-drive socket set from True Value Hardware Stores, who combine value and personal service in over 5,000 locations. And The Wave by the makers of Lava Light simulates the ocean in motion. Soothing, fascinating, incredibly realistic, perfect conversation piece for home or office, The Wave by Lava Light. This is Gene Woods speaking for Card Sharks, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.